closer.
Turn another page. Ooh. In the story of what's waiting for
waiting
you.
For you. Step into the wonder.
Step into the wonder.
Everything you picture.
Oh,
as it comes into you.
Bonjour, my name is European based at Disneyland and me. This is a show where we like to give our opinions on things going on in the past, present and future of Disneyland Paris. As you can tell by our lovely piece of sound music playing in the background, Judy Vision is going to Disneyland! Oh, we're gonna get distracted for the next 3 minutes. Therese myself is back with us for the main show. As always, on the page page, I'm joined by my co-host Mickey. So you are currently hearing in the background the winning song from last year's Junior Song Contest in Warsaw. J'imagine. For France! Ooh. Amazing! France's first ever victory at the G Eurovision Song Contest, and because I did do my homework, it's the first Eurovision event that has been won by France since the 1989 edition of the Young Dancers. And of course, France's last win at the main big deal, the main Eurovision Song Contest, was of course in 1977, when the UK hosted after victory in the previous year, thanks to Bruno Mars, back in 1976, that was. So, it's a big deal here for France. Well, let's let them listen to the rest of it, may as well. Here we go, in a minute now. There you go, that's it. I just wanted to literally play it all the way through. I didn't want to literally tie off a bit. But it's just amazing, Lush. That's such an amazing song. So for France, this is the first time that France is going to be hosting the Junior Eurovision Song Contest. And it's been quite a while, actually, since a Eurovision event was last hosted in France. The last Eurovision event that was hosted in France was in 1999, when they hosted that year's Young Dancers contest in Lyon. And this is going to be the first Eurovision event to be held in Paris, the French capital, since the 1989 Eurovision Young Dancers. So it's a big deal for France, is this. Okay, so I had the idea to do this episode for Opinions Village literally the day after France won. I mean, it was pandemonium the night of last year's Eurovision Song Contest. Literally, my expats, they could not believe it. It had happened, you know. And they partied all night for the next day. We ain't not! You did! In fact, Pluto! Because Pluto, you've just recorded something for me, so you can come bear witness. Pluto, we're about Do you want me to come and bouch? Yeah. My favourite, come to bouch for me, yeah. Because, just go through the camera and say to me what you... Right, yeah. Literally, they literally piped all through the whole night. And literally, I said to George, we woke up the next morning. I literally like, they didn't start piping until 5 a.m. Well, you did! Thank you! You can go back over there. I'll give you a lovely kiss. Thank you, love you. Thank you! That's all I need you for, just a bouch. Just a bouch for that. So I had the idea to do this appearance episode literally the day after, but I wanted to wait until we got some more details, like for example, where and when we are going in Eurovision this year, and we got that details on the actual week of this year's Eurovision Song Contest in Rotterdam, and the press conference was held, which confirmed that Paris will be the host city for this year's Eurovision Song Contest, and the contest will take place this year on the 19th of December. So it's a Christmas contest this year. Yeah, it's a Christmas one. And in fact, this is going to be the I need to find it now. Bear one sec, because, so this is going to be the first time since the 2012 edition, that Eurovision has been hosted in December. It's normally held around about November time, but there have been quite a few years when they have it in December, but normally it is November when they, host the Eurovision, so obviously, it's going to be very, very late this year, especially because that's only, 6 days to go by Christmas. So last year, get your Christmas shopping done all the way before 7:19. The 7:19 party French style. Generally, we are super excited for this. Even more super excited than we would any normal Eurovision year or Eurovision year. It's just amazing. So, what does this tie with Disneyland Paris? Well, here we go. I was thinking, how could we have Disneyland Paris get involved? Now, obviously, of course, we still got, obviously, the effects of the pandemic to still consider. So chances are, this year's contest might have to go a similar route to what we saw last year in Warsaw, where nobody's allowed to travel. So obviously, if you watched last year's contest in Warsaw, you remember that none of the delegations were allowed to travel to Warsaw. They all had to record a live on tape, and that would be used as their performance in the final. And the only people that were allowed in Warsaw were our three presenters and any interval acts. They were the only people that were allowed on stage. And it was pretty produced last year in Warsaw. You generally could not tell the difference. If you put that side by side with the previous years, in BC Silenza, you put them side by side, you watch side by side, you probably wouldn't be able to tell the difference. That's how big it was. So, chances are, that might be how we have to do it again. But I still wanted to make this video, because I still thought, oh, what if so-and-so does so-and-so? Do you know what I mean? What if we're allowed to, say, have people come? Or there are people in Disneyland while the contest is going on. Yeah. So, do you want to read it at the moment? Go on. Right. I'm gonna play the audio from the victory. So, there we go. So, I'm gonna show you the audio, just the audio, but I'll give you the link to the video, but I'd like to play the audio anyway, because I want to recreate the moment that pandemonium happened in our household on that day last year. So, here we go.
We will find out very soon. Okay. Time for France. Let's do it, I think. One more calm turn. Okay, let's do it. France, you're received from online voting. Additional 112 points! It makes you the new leader! You won!
Great, that
this
happened. So
unbelievable.
Amazing.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable. 124. 12 points. Come on.
Friends.
All right. Okay.
Shima Shin and Valentina.
Valentina, friends. Vicky, can you show us the trophy? Valentina, this is all for you. Can you believe it? Can you believe it? This is yours right now. This is a trophy. You won.
Valentina, thank you for your song. Thank you for your performance and for the emotions. We will remember this for a very, very long time.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Reliving that. Thank you for trying to recreate a little bit of the pandemonium that my experts had when it you won. We lost you. Oh, I did complete. You were an absolute wreck. We lost. I don't even need to go and rush get Plur back to Bouch. You basically did it yourself. You were an absolute, out of all my experts, you were an absolute wreck. You could not believe it happened. It was just amazing. So France overall won with a combined score of 200 points, topping the jury and the online vote. So there's no arguing that France won. Okay, so the point of the video: what could Disneyland Paris do, if not to be involved with it? So just in case, obviously, we do have to have another Warsaw situation where nobody can go spectators or the delegations themselves. So like Mickey said, if the park was basically still open while the cons was going on, what could we think we could do? Yeah, just to show that, this Disneyland Paris recognising that this big event is going on. A bit like how you would expect, other organisations and parks in other countries to recognise, for example, if the Olympics or the Car World Games was going on. Yeah, so like that. I'm going to leave the floor to you, too, because it's your home. Well, I think we need to have banners on the lampposts. Yeah. We need to have... Do we know any other? No. So, sadly, at the time of recording this video, the artwork for this year's Jury Song Contest has not been released yet. That will probably be at a later date. But I can imagine it will have the Eiffel Tower. Or probably. Yeah. Because there's a running joke in France, with France, how at the adult Eurovision, almost every single year, their spokesperson is standing next to the Eiffel Tower or behind the Eiffel Tower. It's become quite a bit of a running joke that our commentator, Graham Norton, has picked up a lot. So it would not be surprised to see that for you. No, so we sadly don't have that yet, but yeah, I'd like to see that. Yeah, so on the lamppost, you can have a bit like how when we do an anniversary, yeah, you have on the lamppost the artwork for the anniversary. Yeah, we could put the lamppost the artwork. Yeah, it would be, I mean, it's created in all the different countries. So it's similar to what the main year has been for the last few years. And yeah, so you could for each lamppost have the artwork, but don't in the different countries flags. Yeah, so depending on how many countries, where it's 12 or 18. That probably, if I had to guess how it will go, that's probably a good guess. Yeah, I think we'll definitely have at least 12 countries. Hopefully maybe a bit more. I think some countries that chose to set last year might return, so that could be, yeah. I think that's probably a rough guess to how it would go. Yeah, you think you do that, yeah. So what our idea was, yeah, for the flag parade, what you could do is you could have a character come on for each country. So for each country, you could get it could be any character. It doesn't need to be a specific character country. You could literally have any character come on with that country, and they come on with the contestant, the delegation. That would be a real hoot. It would be quite fun to do. I literally thought that was the first thing I thought. It's like with the fact where you could do a little spill on it, a bit like how in that Eurovision contest, they try to do a little spoiler each year. Well, here for the joke, you could have a character come on. Yeah, you could have on. And then Mickey and Minnie come on at the end. and be like, welcome to the Duo Success 2021, let's meet your host, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So you make a comment at the end and be like, present at the end of the program, just say, here are the hosts, so-and-so. Hope they're going to be. Yeah, which of course we'll find out about in a later time. Yeah, that was my main big idea, is to have literally on the flag parade, you have each delegation joined by a different character. That would be quite good to see. It would be so interesting. I know, all these different characters. It'd be quite good. But going back into the actual park, is there anything else in the parks you could maybe do? What about the opening ceremony? Ooh! I do it there! So literally, we have the opening ceremony. Mm-hmm. Which you get at the beginning of the week. You could have that. Literally, you could host the opening ceremony in the park. But where would you do it though? Because obviously the castle probably will still be under renovations. Good point, Mick. We'll do it in Main Street. But not go near the castle. Okay. Or you could go to the studios. I mean, obviously you saw the construction of the Avengers campus going on behind. What you could do is, because obviously Studio Theatre has been empty ever since the Magic left in 2017, was gone in 2017. So you could actually host it in Studio Theatre. And host it there. We don't really know what goes on in the opening ceremony, do we? No, we don't really watch those in the other one, or do you? No, so we've got no idea. But yeah, you could do it. If you wanted to do it there, you could do it there. So it would be out of the way, nothing going on. Or, as Susan said, just do it in Main Street, but not go all the way down to the castle. So the moment you walk into the park and you see the railway station, you could do it sort of there. That could be a suggestion. Or you could take over Bigiopolis. Mm-hmm. You could do Shopper Theatre. Yep. You could do... There's another theatre in the main park, isn't there? Isn't there Discoveryland Theatre? Yeah, that doesn't get used. Well, it did use to house the Jedi Training Academy, but I don't think that's running anymore, so you could go out there. Yeah. So you got a lot of choice at indoor locations, but what about outdoor locations? Because like Mickey pointed out, there's quite a few construction going on, so you wouldn't want to do a construction. Well, you could either do it in Fantasyland for the main park, or, right, and this is really out of board, you could, if you want to do Studios Park, go to Ratatouille. Yes! Yes! Because the decor of Ratatouille on it is just stunning, and it literally makes you feel like you are in a French city. Yeah! Yes! So do it there. Plaster, I mean. Yeah. Oh! Genius. You are genius. Well done there. Yeah. Well done there. So that's a good idea. Because, yeah, so you could host the opening ceremony in the park. We've given you some good locations there. I think Plaster, I mean, should be the ideal one. Yeah. Because that is where you feel the most French. Yeah. So that could be a good thing. Is there any other things we can think of? Because it is actually quite hard. I mean, I had the idea of how doing the video, but literally, it's actually quite hard to think of what I'll do. We could maybe play the songs. Yeah, over the tunnel. I could do just for the weekend. Yeah, so. Yeah, so just for the week of it, so say you do Friday, Monday, So say you do Friday, Monday of the week of the contest, you just play all the songs. And then come Tuesday, just go back to the normal track. Yeah, which makes our parks famous. Yeah, that could be good. I definitely like your bunting idea. I think that's a good idea. I think if we definitely have the artwork on display in the parks, then obviously guests will know, oh, there's this big event going on, because it actually might drive up more visitors. Even if they actually can't go to the actual venue, because obviously COVID rules won't allow it, they could go, well, instead we'll go into Disneyland, we'll go into Disneyland, and that could help. Yeah. So in case people are wondering, oh, why more people? Well, if you look at the bunting, you see the artwork for this year's Eurovision, you go, ah, that's why. Because there's a big European contest going on, which France got won the rights to host last year. Mm-hmm. Did. Yeah. It's going to be amazing. I genuinely feel I've come up with all I wanted to say, and I'm the one who came up with the idea of the video. You two are less enthusiastic about it. Well, I think it is quite hard because of the pandemic. We don't know. Can we host this year's contest like years past? Or are we going to have to do it like you said, like Warsaw, where the only people who are allowed are the presenters and the interproducts, yeah. So that's a few reasons why it's hard to talk about this. And also, has the parking even think about it? No. So, if you're happy, I'm happy to leave it there. Yeah. Shall I play the song out once more while I sign off? Yeah, okay, good, right. I'll bring it back up. Why did you close it down? Well, I didn't know I should play it again in the end. Or not, but I will do. I'll bring it back up. It's fine, I can go to my history. And just look it up. So, give me one sec. In fact, is what you want to sign off while I'm setting up? Okay, go to the mic. Please look. Okay. Thank you. That's all I'm going to cover for today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget.
Grammarly helps you work more efficiently.
Bloody ads. Don't forget. This year's Jewish Song Contest, the 19th edition, is going to be taking place in Paris. December 19th, 2021. Get involved regardless of your country's hosting or not. Because hey, the UK doesn't even compete, and we still get involved with it. Yeah, we've been involved with it ever since the 13th edition in 2015. So even though we don't compete as a country, we still get involved with it. Don't forget, if you have already subscribed to George's channel, do subscribe, click the subscribe button below. It takes a second. Once you have subscribed, you're going to see single ring content comes out, like, for example, new episodes of Pain Bears with Mickey or the main show with me. And anything else, get in touch. You can get in touch with us by sending your comments below or get in touch with me by my email. The details hiked out on your screen coming up right now. Don't forget to also like and share my videos. That, I think, is about it. So back to you there. Yeah. It's been amazing fun. Quite an unusual show, wouldn't you say, Mick? Yeah. Well, all I have to say is merci to Beauregard, just not to present spectacle. Au revoir! Hit it!
Oups, y'a plus de fleurs au balcon, flûte, elles ont fané sous mes doigts. Oups, c'était pas la bonne saison, mais le printemps reviendra. Oups, j'ai rêvé qu'on était plein à reprendre les murs de nos villes. Et c'est l'empreinte de sur nos écrans tactiles. J'ai plus rien, je suis comme ça, c'est plus fort que moi. J'y crois, les n'y croient plus, les n'y croient pas, c'est pas pour moi. Tout commence par un j'imagine, dans un coin de la tête un rêve qui soudain se dessine. Que plus rien n'arrête, dis-moi toi ce que t'imagines. Chante à tu tête passe le message à ta voisine. Hey, moi je suis prête. La, 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 j'imagine. danse entre vous et moi. Go! Il y a toujours quelque chose à faire, même en plein milieu du salon, sur nos écrans, les mains en l'air, pour faire la révolution. J'y peux rien, je suis comme ça, c'est plus fort que moi. J'y crois, les n'y croient plus, les n'y croient pas, c'est pas pour moi. Tout commence par un j'imagine, dans un coin de ta tête, un rêve qui soudain se dessine. Que plus rien n'arrête, dis-moi toi ce que t'imagines. Chante à tu tête, passe le message à ta voisine. Hey, moi je suis prêt. Toi demain, toi tu fais quoi? Imagine avec moi.
Join us for another amazing video. To see more, check out our most recent upload here, or why not check out that featured playlist? And don't forget to subscribe. What are you waiting for? I highly recommend it.